Hello and welcome to this video presentation for ImagineCup Project Cloud. Currently there are two chapters or levels in Cloud, with more to come soon. The first chapter starts in the sea. The cloud is created out of the ocean and meets a group of larger, more experienced clouds who tell him about the world. Very interested, he decides to go off and see and view the world for himself. Here we see the level icons within the chapter, where we can choose any level from 1 to 4. In this chapter, the cloud's goal is to get away from the sea and towards the land, to have a look at a bit more of the world. A mini instruction page tells the players what they need to accomplish in this level. The crowd is controlled using the accelerometer to change direction. Using a fingertip on the screen, we can change the camera angle so the cloud can look around. Placing two fingers on the screen and spreading them or pushing them in together will zoom in or out the camera. The minimap on the left bottom shows the location of the cloud and the location of the goal, where the goal is a collection of big clouds. A red warning sign marks the edge of the map where the cloud can no longer continue moving. Red or green arrows on the minimap mark which areas a cloud should go to or should stay out of. The game awards players points or scores in terms of 1, 2 or 3 clouds, 3 being the best. In this level, we see that the cloud can absorb smaller clouds in it, which are outlined green. However, the player's cloud must avoid clouds that are outlined red, as these clouds will take moisture away from the cloud and absorb it. Once again, the main goal is the group of larger clouds that was speaking to the small cloud at the start of the game. Now let's take a look at the second chapter of this game. The second chapter is based on the land. We see that the cloud comes across a village and some dry trees. The ground is very barren and a fire starts. The fire soon spreads, and the cloud realizes he must add more water to the environment in order to balance out the ecology of the environment. The tasks given to the player gradually grow in difficulty from level to level. As we can see here, the player tries to absorb the smaller green clouds and tries to avoid the larger red clouds. Areas marked with a red cross on the map are dry, and the cloud must rain. This is accomplished by pressing the water bar on the right. An arrow denotes whether the water bar is filling up or going down. Raining will make the water bar of the cloud go down, but will raise the moisture of the ground area. The goal of the game is to raise the moisture level of all the dry areas, so they are denoted by a green tick on the mini-map. This means that the cloud has successfully converted all the dry areas into habitable locations. Once again, when the mission is complete, the little cloud meets up with its group of big cloud friends. That concludes our presentation. Thank you for watching.